What's going on, Synthic Movement? So today I'm gonna be basically talking to you guys about a main issue with these second gens with the AC system. It's a really simple fix. Hopefully this is your problem if you're having issues this summer or whenever you guys are watching it. But I'm really trying to save some guys this summer from having to just be boiling in their car, because I've done it for two summers and I finally got sick of it and finally figured out what this issue was. But basically, a main issue is accumulator going out in these second gens. Accumulator goes out and then basically it clogs the orifice tube and it sends out hot air. So that's why you might be getting some hot air in your system. So in my case, it was the accumulator, the orifice tube. I am recording this after, so I could verify that it really was this issue. And right now it's just insane with this AC actually blowing some cold air. Basically, the accumulator goes out, clogs it, and one way you could read this is from getting a pressure gauge. You can get at any local auto store, go pick that up, and yeah, hopefully you could rent it, hook it up to your high pressure and low pressure, and get that reading. Basically, in my case, it was accumulator, so it was reading really high pressure reading. So I was getting like 180 psi, and usually it should be ballparking around like 150. I was getting 180. So that's why I kind of knew that my accumulator was bad. And so finally replaced that in the line and ended up working. It's just insane, blowing some cold air. So in this video, I am gonna be showing you guys how to replace those two components. One thing too is, which kind of sucks with the orifice, is you can't just replace the little tube. You can't just replace, you know, the little filter. You gotta replace the whole line to end line. So the whole liquid line has to be replaced, but it is what it is. It was still simple. It's just a little more expensive. It's $30, which wasn't too crazy. One thing that would really suck and you guys need to look at is if you got the same high and low pressure reading. This is one of the easiest dead giveaways for a bad compressor. And compressors kind of suck because they're so damn expensive. They're kind of easy to replace, but they're around like $200-$300, and that's remanufactured. So if you get it straight from Dodge or whatever, it'd probably be like $500 OEM. It'd be ridiculous. So hopefully this will be in your case, but like I said, this accounts for a lot of AC issues with these trucks. So if you do have this problem, go pick that up and then watch this video and you'll be able to figure out how to install this. It's relatively simple. You just need a fuel disconnect, or it's fuel and AC line disconnect tool, and you'll be able to replace this.
All right guys, so basically for the orifice tube, the end line, you're gonna be taking this off that connects to the whole condenser, but this one is a 5/8 to take this off. So you just put that disconnect tool in there, pop it in. I'm gonna show you guys on the accumulator itself, but I'm just gonna tell you guys right now, just pop it in, it'll release that spring and you just pull back up and that thing will come off. Sometimes you'll have a little bit of pressure in the system, so it'll be a little harder to actually like pull out, but it pulls out pretty easy. So if I could set you guys up in here. So I got you guys set up right here, and this is one of the lines we're taking off to actually get the accumulator off. So I'm using 3/4-inch disconnect on that one. So I'm just gonna be pulling up, and then right when I feel that spring come loose, then I'm gonna pull the line down, and then you guys will see that. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that right now. Alright guys, so I'm gonna try to film this pretty quick because my camera's about to die. That's why I also wasn't able to show you guys too much of, you know, taking off those lines. Basically, for the orifice tube, the liquid line with the you know, the high pressure liquid line, this is what this was. And basically show you guys that this first connection, take that off, and then we have the connection in the back by the firewall. And that was, if we could see, that was that little line has a half inch line, and that's the one you take off. Now people say that you gotta take, you know, the intake and maybe even the battery, but for me, all I had to do is actually just take off the hold down. I was able to kind of maneuver it. Obviously it's a, you know, one piece line that's kind of hard to bend. So I was able to actually kind of maneuver that, and then, you know, it actually has to pop out right here. So that's why you just take off that hold down bolt, and this will just slide up freely and you could just remove it. So that was pretty easy. And now I'm going to show you guys the accumulator. So that's this bastard back here. I was trying to get that line off, and then camera's about to die, so I just shut it off. And that one, you just use a 3/4 disconnect tool. And that was the big one back there. That's the big fitting. You just snap that in until the spring, and then you gotta pull it back. The thing was, is I actually didn't have enough room, because, you know, it's held down right here. If you guys can see, let me move that wire. So this thing back here, that little clamp, the little C-clamp that goes around the whole thing to actually hold the accumulator, that I just twisted off this bolt. It's 11 millimeter. You can see that thing when you zoom in on it, that baby down in there. You just spin that out, and then see that, you could actually move it pretty free. So then I was able to get some pulling power, and then let me zoom back out, I was able to pull that thing back. So those are actually pretty easy. This one that goes to the compressor, that wasn't too bad. So that one just pulled out pretty easy, but this was the one that was the biggest bitches back there by the firewall. So now that that's out, I could really just spin this thing out. Watching that one to come out, there you go. Now it's out. Oh god, line went flying. And now all I have to do is take this sensor off and transfer that on to the new accumulator, and I'm going to show you guys as much as I can before this damn camera dies of reinstalling everything. What a beautiful thing AC is. It's crazy. Look at this. Freaking 95 degrees outside. I'm just chilling in here. You know what I'm saying? This is beautiful. Get your AC done today. Figure it out. Don't be the guy like I was, freaking running around town with the windows down
and you're sitting at a light just sweating your ass off and your back's getting all sweaty and shit, don't do that. Get your shit done today. So hopefully this video helps you out so you can get your AC done and be chillaxing with the nice windows up. Again, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video.